Well, hello once again. Buzz Killington here, and my little series on characters who don't get much love in Tacticus has eventually and inevitably made its way to Incisus, the red-headed stepchild of the Ultramarines. You think medic, you think pretty much anyone else but him. But does he deserve his rep? Kinda. I mean, let's think about it. He's not tremendously exciting, is he? I mean, he looks okay in his shiny white armor. His gun disappears really. I've just noticed how his gun just like vanishes from his right hand when he's pressing the button there. That's actually quite disturbing. But okay. What can you say about him? He doesn't really set your world alight, does he? I'd like to do a quick shout out to Jay Campbell if he sees this, because I saw him on Facebook, one of the Tacticus groups, having recently promoted Incisus to legendary with the proclamation "No character left behind." Good luck with that. He'd actually got him fairly high, and as you can see, well, this isn't my Incisus. This is the marketing build Incisus. I've just put him up to 35 each to give an insight into what his strength actually is at that level. But I think, pretty sure this guy, Jay, is wasn't that far off this. So yeah, he beefed him up. Why beef Incisus up? Just as a general point, if you're new, you're starting out, Incisus you get pretty much straight away. He's easy to unlock, he's unlocked as part of the first campaign, and he is pretty good for keeping troops alive in the Indomitus campaign to help you get those all too precious free stars. So really, most people tend to put just enough resources into him to keep him alive, keep him useful, and then they discard him and move on. But is there an argument for giving him a bit more love, and when would you do that? So let's start by taking a look at his stats. Obviously, range, he's got movement 3, armor's reasonable, 592. It's a bit better than Tigerius at this level, I think. He's actually got a decent amount of health. Piercing is his strength. I'll never forget when I playing one of the Indomitus Mirror campaigns. I think it was it might have been 75, when I was trying to take Marnius Kalgar down, and he has all the Ultramarines with him. And Incisus came wandering down off the slope towards my Aleph Null, and hit him and took half his health. I nearly died of shock. But yeah, Incisus has piercing, which quite a lot of people often forget. And at this strength level, which is obviously nowhere near what it was in that particular mission, he deals 1215 damage, one hit, 80% pierce ratio. That is actually surprisingly good. It's something like 900-ish, 900 to 1000, it's in that range, can't be bothered to do the exact maths, of damage. And yet he hits hard. He hits hard. One hit, but he can make them count. So he's actually a bit tougher than you think in terms of a battle. But of course, there are a lot of better choices, right? He is a healer. Can heal a friendly unit's health as its action. Equals the healer's damage multiplied by the highest number of hits of any of their weapons. So he's got one hit. 1215 damage. That's a decent amount of health healed, in fairness. So, but the problem is, of course, it's just on one guy. You got to use the action one guy. You don't get the overall aura of healing that Isabella gets that makes her so useful. Looking at the abilities, the Narthesium, again, non-mechanical, makes sense. An adjacent friendly non-mechanical unit that takes lethal damage has a 90% chance to be saved unless overkilled and brought up to 1141 health at level 35. This is actually better than Nauseous Rotbones ability, Nauseous Rotbones passive, simply because it's all friendly, non-mechanical, not just only Chaos. So he could potentially raise up Chaos, he could raise up Nauseous Rotbone if he died, he could raise up anyone, it doesn't matter. But again, unless overkilled, can only be triggered once per turn. So 90% chance is pretty damn strong. I have seen this happen in games where he's just resurrected someone, you kill him again, the next turn he resurrects him again. It can just keep going until you just take the guy out. So yeah, he it's better in a way than Isabella. Isabella's active, obviously, you can bring back one character and two summons, potentially, that's it, then you're done. Whereas with this guy, you can keep resurrecting people turn after turn after turn after turn, theoretically. So it's actually good in that sense. He's got combat restoratives. Heals himself and all adjacent friendly units by that. Health of 1853 health of Imperial. So he goes in the middle of a packed group. He can do a massive combat boost, health boost, on all units around him, with particular incentive for Imperial. Extra 742 at that level to Imperial. But again, he's not stingy. So by no means as a healer is he anything to be sniffed at. The problem is, of course, again, Isabella is just so much better. You group her, you group units around her, she just sits there in the center and just heals any damage pretty much that the outside units take. Of course, you can only do so much, and it can be overwhelmed if, like, you're high in onslaught levels, for instance, and the Termagants and Hormagaunts hit really hard. But she's damn useful, and she can keep things alive for a long, long time. And Incisus is more of a directed weapon, rather, it doesn't really have an AoE. You've got to use him and use him wisely. So, unfortunately, for that regard, I don't know, would he be considered, is he worse than Nauseous Rotbone? I don't know. I think he might actually be equal to, maybe at least as good as Nauseous Rotbone. Stats-wise, I don't know, because Nauseous Rotbone obviously has the Death Guard aura. He is resilient, disgustingly so. It sticks around. But again, he's a very much a Chaos healer. And he will heal Imperial units if you direct him to do so, but he won't. His passives won't really do anything to help them. So on that regard, he's good, but overall the problem is, if you have a choice between Incisus and Isabella, Isabella is so much better. Why would you not take her? And I'm aware I'm saying this during the middle of battle pass in which you can collect Isabella shards. Why would you not devote your attention to her? So what the question then becomes, when would you take Incisus? When would you put resources into Incisus? Basically, if you don't have Isabella, and you want things like legendary events. Legendary events, he can be useful there because he does have piercing. He also has one hit. So there's a couple of events right there. And yet, just because he's a healer, he can do some good for you. If you don't have Isabella, and you're not likely to unlock her anytime soon, he's not necessarily a bad choice. Obviously, it's very track dependent, and it depends which particular opponents you're facing as to how strong he is. He hits fairly hard against non-armored units or low armored units. He will stand a good chance of taking them out face to face and hand to hand, or hand to Narfisium or whatever if he has to. So that is worth considering. But again, when it comes down to it, if it was a choice between Incisus or Isabella, it's always going to be Isabella, isn't it? Just because Isabella is so much better. So I think, in conclusion, Incisus may be a little unfairly maligned, but he's just going to gradually slip by the wayside. Once you unlock Isabella, that's it. He's gone. Bye-bye, Incisus. You stay in the surgery and deal with skinned knees and grazes and stuff like that, while Isabella's out on the battlefield saving lives. But yeah, let me know what you think. Tell me in the comments, how high have you got your Incisus? Do you think he's worth sinking resources into? Do you think I'm off the mark? And also let me know, what character would you like me to look at next, maybe? Do you think any unloved characters you think deserve the Buzz Killington gaze to discover if they have hidden talents and are kind of diamonds in the rough? So, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. Until next time.